And Ozell Powell, number 78, wearing white, has just picked up a Florida turnover on the opening possession of the football game, and the Alabama Crimson Tide, as we come to the dome for the SEC championship game presented by Dr. Pepper. You see the big tackle grabbing the errant ball as it floated through the air ever so softly, and suddenly the roof of the dome is an endangered species. I mean, this Alabama crowd just about blew it off. And it is first and goal for the Tide. It is no good. Oh, does that lift Florida? As if the Texas win over Nebraska had already sent them among the clouds. Getting out of that circumstance without having points scored against it really has to stir them up. Second down and 10 from the 20. Looking, and down he goes. It's the big man, Ozell Powell, who has had an interception. Now he has a sack. Alexander is in the backfield as they split him now with Dennis Riddle. And the man in motion is Goss, and Kitchens back. Has time, got a man wide open. That's Riddle. First down, more. And all the way to the end zone. Touchdown. Point. Yes, Colin Cooper. It is blocked by Fernando Bryant, the cornerback. Alexander now is in the backfield for them, and Kitchens looking for a pass. Will go down in a sack at the 16. 7-6 Alabama after one quarter. Back after this word from our ABC station. To give Danny Wuerffel a little more time, make the Alabama defenders run a little farther. Ball is thrown nicely, softly to Ike Hillard. Wuerffel has been decked one time hard already tonight. He throws very quickly again to Reidal. Both to hide behind for a flash of a second and broke free. First touchdown. You've got Taylor, Hilliard, and Green all over on this side, and he throws it the other way, and the pass is caught by Anthony. It's a two-point conversion. It's 14-7, Florida. Looking down on guard. Purple quickly. Is having all the way to the Alabama 45-yard line. Ike Hillard is the wide man to the bottom of the picture. And Williams goes in motion. Wuerffel had a little trouble getting a handle on it, but now gets his pass away, and he's got Williams wide open. Sigler can't get him, and he'll score. Touchdown, Gator. Well, that's a tailback out there at a wide spot, and it results in a 45-yard touchdown.
The first pass that he's thrown to a back 2 weeks ago.
Kitchen. At the 10. In a game. Working out of the shotgun. And throws quickly to Ike Hillard. And Hillard will do the rest. First game of 200 yards by Wuerffel. 25-yard try. Oh, he hammered it, and it's good.
It helps when you're up by 14 points.
Poor field position. Here the whole second quarter, Florida's been starting from well up the field and staying home. Do your job. Kitchens pass to the sideline and caught by Vaughn. Great catch by Michael Vaughn.
He was not a good sign.
Here's Bob Stoops right there, the young man who came from Kansas State. Coming, Johnny Rutledge, and finally absolutely changed the world. That ball is thrown again hard. This time it's drilled to Marcel West. Third and two. Coming again. Yep. His man Riddle, first and goal, Alabama at the Florida nine. Right foot, Kitchens on his back again, but this time he completed the pass.
Complaining that Vaughn kind of pushed him away.
So our halftime score at the Georgia Dome is Florida 24, Alabama 14. The Rudd's wandering all over the place. He and State were everywhere right now. Wuerffel rolls to get a little time and throws, and the pass has been complete.
I like that.
Goss is waiting for it back inside the 35. Six.
Last week.
Riddle. Touchdown. Good field position, and that ball is caught. That's going to be a touchdown, Michael Vaughn. 94 yards, no flag.
a big play from a team that's not used to making a lot of big plays.
Build for this, and you got the feeling that we might be in for a scuffle, and we have it right now. At the 19-yard line, and we're coming up on 11 o'clock. I know some of you might be flipping around for your local news, but have a seat. This is a good one. 31-28, Florida leading Alabama by 3 for the Southeastern Conference Championship. The crowd down at that end of the field, mostly Alabama, they're trying to help. And you got a sack as Staten found his way through for the second time in the second half. And so the loss is back to the 15-yard line. It'll be second down and 14.
Now every time that Staten gets up there, they got to worry about him coming again.
Wuerffel's got a guy. It's Green. He's just a burner. And it's a touchdown for Florida. Simply outran Fernando Bryant.
Can't keep coming up with these points. They came into this ball game averaging only 24 points a game.
28-28. Here's the blitz. Passes away. Alexander has it. He's attacked immediately by Johnny Rutledge again.
To help the offenses.
Freed up the arms of the offensive line. That thing is worth on. He's out of bounds at the 36-yard line. Number 7 in the white shirt. Thing, I'm doing all I can do.
You see there, Gene, they're talking to Bryant. Says, you got to see the ball. The direction.
This is against Alabama, too.
Oh, yeah. Gene doesn't like it.
Offside on the defense. 5 yards. First down.
What the quarterback is doing is controlling the line of scrimmage with his cadence, and sometimes he's getting them to jump, and other times they're guessing right, and they're getting right between the center guard gap, and they're getting the quarterback before he almost gets away from center.
So at the end of the third quarter, the SEC championship presented by Dr. Pepper. It is Florida 38, Alabama 28. Back after this message and a word from our ABC station. Inside the 22 of Alabama, leading by 10 points. There's a pass thrown to the corner of the end zone. Touchdown, Reidal. Over in the corner of the field here.
It's defensive backs not being able to see the ball. You're going to see the blitz here. 87 Rudd gets rid of the ball. The defensive back just doesn't see it. Townsend. Anthony's going to look back, but Townsend never sees the ball.
And it translates to touchdown.
Well, they do. I think the wide receivers do a good job of just playing possum. When the ball's getting close, their eyes don't get big and they don't jump too soon. They wait till the ball gets there so the defensive back doesn't react too soon, and by the time he does, they've got it.
You can see that Wuerffel has gone over 400 yards.